What's going on, America? This is Kevin from Kevin's Corner. And I just got a question. Does Alexandria Cortez have a governor in her brain, a filter, something to stop the diarrhea of ignorance that just flows from her mouth constantly without even checking it and saying, wow, this smells like doo-doo. Maybe I shouldn't poop my pants out in public and expose myself. See, that's the difference between, say, a kid, a baby, and a grown-up. You know, you're sitting there saying to yourself, I'm out amongst people. I don't think I should just go ahead and poop on myself because it shows that I lack control. I lack discipline. I don't mind stinking and revealing all of the garbage that's inside of me. Well, she poops herself constantly. She poops up her thoughts. She has diarrhea of the mouth, and it leaks out nothing but nasty, stinking boo-boo thoughts. So when she gets online and tweets something about Ivanka Trump being overseas, first of all, are you jealous? Do you think you would make a better representative? You know, she tried to allude to the fact that the only reason she's over there is because she's riding in on daddy's coattail, and that's the only thing that qualifies her to be there. Now, the crazy part is Ivanka Trump, since she's been in the White House, has done more for America than Alexandria Cortez has done. She blew the deal in New York when it came down to Amazon. She's doing nothing to help the people in her area. And I wonder, is somebody going to challenge this lady coming up in 2020? Get her out. Do I need to move to New York and run for Congress against her? I mean, I hate living. I wouldn't like living there, but it almost might be worth it because this woman is ridiculous. Now, she goes and she throws off on Ivanka Trump. So there goes woman power and sticking together and supporting women in advancement based off of their skills, their knowledge, their efforts. What she's saying is the only reason you got there is because daddy let you get there. You're not smart. Even though you have made millions, possibly billions of dollars with your own business and your own clothing line. Even though you have gotten in the White House and you didn't run for office. She's given up all of the stuff that she could have had if she'd have stayed in the private sector. She decided, I'm going to get in the White House and make a difference, okay? And that's exactly what she's doing. Even though Ivanka Trump speaks eloquently and intelligently, and it makes sense, and it's usually backed up with some type of facts, reasoning, or some data, something. Alexandria just throws stuff out there constantly. She doesn't care. It's just walking around, just straight up pooping all over the place in public. And the Democrats are walking around like they don't smell that doo-doo diaper, like they don't smell the boo-boo that comes out of her mouth constantly. I smell it from here. So now, what I suggest, if she's that bright, she's a witty light bulb, why don't she have a discussion with Ivanka Trump? Maybe they can go one-on-one in a debate over some things that Alexandria feel passionate about. Or how about she debate Candace Owens? Notice that she's never debated anyone. Even in her primary, the guy thought he was going to win. He didn't even debate her. Now, that's how easy she's had it. She has been bubble wrapped. Somebody needs to step to her and on a public platform and have a debate. Challenge all of these stupid thoughts and statements that's coming out of her mouth and actually call her to the carpet on it. Because right now, she's running around leaving doo-doo pies all over America on Twitter, down at the border, everywhere you go. You're seeing little droplings of Alexandria Cortez. And the Democrats are doing nothing but trying to sweep it up. Yeah, that's what they're doing. Instead of calling her out and saying, you know what? You stink. Everything you say stinks. Everything. You know, and the sad part about it is I'm not, all right, now this might be a little sexist. This might sound sexist. But you ever see somebody who, and this goes, actually, it's not sexist. Forget that mess. This get applied to men or women. Women, you ever seen a man who was handsome, but yet you listen to him and you start observing him and he becomes uglier by the minute. And all of a sudden, you can't get past his ugly personality and character. Now, all of a sudden, physically, he starts to look ugly. You're like, ooh, he just, every time I see him, at first, I thought he was hot. Same thing with a woman. I'm not necessarily even attracted to her. I don't find her that hot. Some guys do. But I also wouldn't say she was ugly. But the more they put her out there, the more she's on TV, the more she's up there spewing out ignorance and garbage and falsehoods, all of those things. When I see her, she goes from, I mean, you know, she's an all right looking chick to, she just starts to look disgusting to me. And it has nothing to do with her being a woman. It has something to do with her insides starting to leak out and overshadow her outsides. That's right. See, when I start seeing her now, what I see is boo-boo. That's what I see. I was like, man, started off looking like a, you know, a spunky, spicy little young lady who ran for Congress. And now all of a sudden, what's that brown that's kicking in? Is that, are those corn and peas in that? Ew, is those, are those flies on that? Is it, is there maggots in? Oh my God, every time I see her, boo-boo. Now, you've been listening to Kevin and Kevin's Corner. I hate to have to be graphic like that, but when you're dealing with poop like that, you have to bring it home. I don't want nobody to think it's cute, see? Yeah, you have to use extreme examples, let somebody downplay it and say, well, I mean, you know, there are some poop that don't look that bad. No, all poop looks horrible. I will not even give her the benefit of the doubt and say, no, well, you know, baby poop. No, poop. She's straight poop. Now, you've been listening to Kevin and Kevin's Corner. Check me out every Wednesday. Live at Kevin's Corner on YouTube. And also don't forget to check me out on my radio blog talk show. Hit like, hit share, hit subscribe and the notification button. And check out Extreme Tees. Put my name in the promo code Kevin. You'll get a 20% discount. Links in the bottom. Want to donate to Kevin and Kevin's Corner? Feel free. There's a link in the bottom. Do that as well. Find me on Facebook and the Twitter. And we'll see you next time in Kevin's Corner. God bless.